Good morning. It's 4:45, and as I mentioned, the wind's going to be down today. However, and we're not in the wind advisory. The windiest areas is southern Minnesota, northern Iowa, northern parts of Illinois, Indiana, and Ohio, and over into the Pennsylvania area. So our outlook here for the precip for the next 24 hours does not include much of the Red River Valley, but we did see a fair amount of light snow in northern Minnesota. This afternoon, it'll continue to snow. You can just tell the bands of the wraparound of moisture from this big eastern Ontario or central Ontario low. Our hour-by-hour forecast does call for a little more periods of very light snow. Don't expect any accumulation in northwestern and northern Minnesota. And by the end of the day, we'll start to clear the clouds. The real clearing will come overnight tonight, and as a result, the temperatures will be dropping. Let's see what the computer says. 35, let's chop 10 degrees off of that. We'll be down in the mid-20s tomorrow morning, and again Thursday morning, and again Friday morning. The good news is, with the sunshine and the clear, tomorrow we should bust into the low 50s, and each and every day we'll be in the low 50s. But computers is not able to determine our extreme weather here in the Central Plains. Looks like on Thursday, then, more sunshine and also in the 50s. The threat of the severe thunder, or at least thunderstorms of significance, doesn't look like a severe weather outbreak, will be down in the Southern Plains, Texas and Oklahoma, still under the gun for some more beneficial rain. It's starting to be drought-busting rain down there. Well, we're thinking that we're going to get a fair amount of snow. It did snow yesterday evening, and we do have more some flurry activity going on. Yes, even in and around the Fargo-Moorhead area, up towards Cooperstown, northern parts of Barnes County getting snow, and we have snow coming at us from southern parts of Manitoba. But we didn't get a whole lot of significant snow accumulation, the Bemidji-Baudette-Thief River area. Here's where. It's central North Dakota, from Williston down through Richardton, Bismarck, all the way down into the western parts of Logan and McIntosh County, out there in the Ashley and Linton area. Then you go over to the Great Lakes, you got some snow, but it's New England that's getting hit with some rain, inch to two today there, and the Central Plains from southern Nebraska through Kansas down into Oklahoma, south of Oklahoma City. They're getting starting the seedbed for some rather significant thunderstorms later today. Again, I don't expect a widespread severe weather outbreak, but down there in Tornado Alley, things can happen rather quickly. 17 to 20, gusting to about 30 are the winds out of the northwest today. This morning we start at 32, Fergus Falls, Elbow Lake, Detroit Lakes. Low mid-30s there in the southern parts of the valley. Carrington, a cool 28, and 32 up in the northern valley. Looks like 29 Bemidji. Carrington, you're the coolest this morning. For the next couple of days, more showers of rain or snow. Cloudy, windy, cool, and damp today. And then for Wednesday, sunny, breezy, and cool. And each and every day heading into and through the weekend, we're going to start warming things up, and it does look like by the weekend with some near 60 or into the low 60s for Sunday into Monday, and a few rain showers possible Sunday and today. But otherwise, we're kind of going dry here for the next week. All right, where are the markets at this morning? We're going to check in with Scott Shelady and get his take on commodity markets right after the break.